Hey now, Rodney R. Dixon here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to remotely control another computer from your own computer over the internet completely free of charge and easily. This is done by using a program called TeamViewer, available for free at www.teamviewer.com. Now, TeamViewer is brilliant in the sense that it can be as complex or as simplistic as you want it to be. It could be as complex as in the sense that you could install it on the machines, you could ensure that it only runs during certain times, during certain intervals, that the person remotely accessing your computer only has certain accesses and privileges, you could set specific passwords and what have you, or it could be as basic as you can both run the software, you don't even have to install it, it can run directly from the standalone installer slash client, and you could use it for example, a one-time use, and then shut it down, and of course, by shutting it down, you ensure the added security of not having TeamViewer open for potential hackers to hack into your machine and take control of your computer. It should be noted that, as added benefits to TeamViewer, TeamViewer does not work by IP address. For example, if I have TeamViewer open, somebody who has my IP address cannot necessarily have access to my computer through TeamViewer. Instead, it works through a user ID that the TeamViewer servers provide to you. And they, of course, also provide you automatically with a password. This password can be changed at your discretion, and you can set your own password. Also worth noting, if you do grant access to another party to your computer using TeamViewer, you don't have to worry that they'll be doing things behind your back. Whatever they do on your computer, you see on your computer screen. It's all done live, provided, of course, you're in front of your computer screen. I don't recommend running TeamViewer and then leaving and not, you know, being in front of your computer screen to see what's going on. Anyway, let me show you how TeamViewer functions. Now I'm going to be showing you TeamViewer in its most basic state, basically running the software from the standalone executable file and how it functions. So, like as I mentioned, TeamViewer all-in-one is the suite I'm going to be using now. Yes, individual modules for TeamViewer are available in the download section. However, at the size of the all-in-one suite, it's just under 5 megs, and the ease of functionality that it provides, I highly recommend the all-in-one software suite. So anyway, you go along and download the all-in-one software suite. In fact, I should re-show you this. Sorry about that. Download the all-in-one software suite. I'm going to download it. Here we go. Yes, I'm going to overwrite. In my case, it doesn't take very long. There we go. It's already downloaded. Now I'm going to run the TeamViewer all-in-one software. I accept. And here we go. When TeamViewer first opens, it offers you the option. You could either install it, or you can run it. And it reads, TeamViewer is executed without installation. This does not require administrative privileges. Great. Gonna go ahead. I accept the license agreement. Great. And you had a glimpse of it prior, because I had it open prior. But I'm gonna give you a... it's gonna take a few seconds before it opens up, but once it opens up, hopefully things will be more clear. Here we go. As for the TeamViewer interface. First off, in the right, computers and contacts, you can create your own contact list. This, of course, requires that you sign up for a TeamViewer account. I don't know if that costs money. I'm not interested. There we go. Close. This is the way the TeamViewer interface looks. The first thing to ensure when you boot up TeamViewer is you have to ensure that you have the green light in the corner and it reads ready to connect, secure connection. What this ensures is that you have a internet connection, you have a proper connection to the TeamViewer servers and therefore can use TeamViewer. TeamViewer is broken down into two sections, allowing remote control, where here you have, once again, your ID provided to you by TeamViewer and a password, which you can change by clicking that. See, you could create a new random password or set a personal password. There you go, you could do that. And essentially, this is the information, the user ID and the password, that you would be providing to the other party if you wanted them to have control of your machine. If you wish to control somebody else's machine, they have to provide you with the user ID and password, and you're going to use it in this section, Control Remote Computer, by which you'll be able to access their computer. So I'm going to show you that right now. I have TeamViewer set up on two computers right now. On this computer, we're going to be using this computer that you're seeing right now to control another computer. So, Control Remote Computer, Partner ID. I need the partner ID. The partner ID for my remote computer, since I'm right next to it, is as follows: 607-997-962. There we go. And I have the choice to either remote control or file transfer. File transfer is quite simply transferring files. Remote control is, of course, remotely controlling your computer. In this case, I'm going to show you how remote control works. I'm going to click on Connect to Partner. Connecting. It reads right here, authenticating. Please enter the password that is displayed on your partner's computer. So the password for my partner's computer is 5034. Log on. And there we go. It reads the user ID of my partner's computer. TeamViewer, free license, non-commercial use only. I'm going to maximize the screen. It is maximized because it turns out it's an 800 by 600 screen. Okay. View. Let's see what view. What can we do here? Quality. Okay, we could play with some options. Anyway, that's just fine. So, first off, this is an indication of that. This is an indication to the remote, to the other computer that I currently have access. It's grayed out to show that, you know, this basically doesn't pertain to me. This pertains to the other guy. I could slide that away so it's out of my view. Great. So now I could work with the other computer. This was the website that the other computer was on. As you can see, the motion isn't 100% there. It isn't as rapid as it could be, as quick as it could be. But considering that you're remotely controlling somebody else's computer over the internet, it's still pretty good. In this instance, I showed that I could access their computer, including their hard drives, their documents, and what have you. Here's their firewall that I have up there, things that are opened. Here was the website they're on. If they're connected to the internet, I can look things up on their computer anyway. I won't go through that. Well, yeah, you know, why not? Here. Now I just typed in random characters into Google, and there you go. Library of Information Research Group. Well, there you go. So, as simple as that, I can, of course, move around files, I could access their computer. This can be a very useful tool, especially in the sense of aiding someone who, let's say, they don't have the computer knowledge that you have, and you wish to troubleshoot or fix something on their computer, maybe configure their computer, such as configure an antivirus or something of that nature. This can be a great tool in order to aid them in configuring their computer. All you have to do, as shown in this video, is you both download and run TeamViewer. They provide you with the access, the user ID and the password, and then you control their computer. Of course, it should be noted that everything I'm doing on this computer, even down to the movement of my cursor, can be seen on the other computer at the same time. Now let me try this. Oh, I was moving around the cursor on my end as well, trying to fight it in both senses. Let's see if I click on a link. Or you know what? I'll change this. There we go. The host, the other computer in this case, and myself have access to the client's computer at the same time. which is a benefit, as you can both collaboratively work on something at the same time. So there you go. A great little tool, great little piece of software, considering it's under 5 megs. I think it's unfortunate that you have to go through the TeamViewer servers, that you can't do it by IP. I understand why, you know, added security, and maybe there's somehow money to be had by TeamViewer, considering they're offering a free product. However, other than that, it's just a great piece of software. It works extremely well. It's a lot easier to use and configure than Microsoft's own remote desktop connection. Back in the day, there was a similar functionality using NetMeeting, which was also a little more difficult to configure, but it worked great. Unfortunately, NetMeeting is now a discontinued product and cannot be used on modern-day computers, I believe. It just can't be used whatsoever, so that's unfortunate. But there you go. So, great piece of software, works great. Let me show you this one last thing. When you're done with TeamViewer, you can click this X, and it closes down your access to the person's computer. Of course, the person can also just close down their TeamViewer if they're tired of what you're doing or question what you're doing as you have access. There's a sponsored session window that it comes up. It says, this was a free session sponsored by TeamViewer. TeamViewer sessions are free of charge for personal use. We thank you for playing fair, in the sense that they'd like you to buy a license or like them on Facebook or what have you. But overall, if that's the only little annoyance you come across when using TeamViewer, I think it's well worth the effort. Well, anyway, so there you go. I hope this information helps, and as usual, all the best.